Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, let me tell you about my first Ramadan as a new Muslim. I looked forward to it so much. I didn't really know how to prepare. And when Ramadan came, after my children went to bed on that first evening, I sat on my own and I had no idea what to do. Then came day 15, day 16, day 17 of that Ramadan. Nobody called me. Nobody asked how I was, and nobody was there to advise me about what I could be doing, and nobody cared about me. And worse, I was looking on social media and everybody was saying, great to see auntie and uncle again after so long, banging iftar tonight with 30 of the family, can't wait for X, Y, and Z. I felt the isolation that new Muslims feel. I also was in a community where my daughters and I were rejected for 7 years due to a member of the family not wanting us to be in their family. SubhanAllah. That meant that even after Ramadan, the family would go off and have their Eid and my daughters and I would be on our own. These are the spiritual and, you know, emotional struggles that new converts go through all too routinely. Isolation and loneliness and even homelessness is rising amongst sisters. I want us to help Solace this year to become incredibly successful and well-resourced in order to carry on helping sisters who make that huge leap to become Muslim and are then, subhanAllah, our responsibility. I always like to support an international charity, but we must remember that the Ummah cannot thrive if the sisters coming in, the sisters on their own, which is a really, really tough challenge, or the sisters with children, struggling with bills, struggling with loneliness, struggling with isolation and perhaps domestic violence. If we leave them alone, we are putting this Ummah at risk for decades to come. Solace UK has developed a very clear and structured service. Their support scheme is unique because it provides each new convert with a specific support worker, kind of like the Ansar system, if you think about it. They provide mediation services for when families are broken, emotional support when they feel down or alone, help in improving their social network. So important to securing a future that is one of thriving rather than just surviving. Emergency temporary accommodation for those made homeless due to reversion. Counseling for victims of emotional and physical abuse, helping service users work through marital problems, and step-by-step action plans for service users finding it difficult to adopt Islamic practices, such as praying 5 times a day, hijab, and fasting in Ramadan. Plus emergency support for Revert sisters who have doubts in faith, as well as thoughts of wishing to leave Islam. Please don't forget the sisters who are new to the deen, who live just around the corner from you and are praying to Allah Ta'ala for help. Jazakum la khair.